We brought in the head, the president of the Italian Association of Modinari. And Modinari is almost a lost art that's been revived since the 70s. And Nato was one of the early people who constructed this revival.
What I really liked was that a little power-packed package of Italy got delivered to us, because I really got a flavor of Italy off this guy, but I especially got the flavor for the spirit of Modinari.
The thing that made it really interesting, Nato spoke only Italian. So we actually had a translation team of about 5 or 6 people who translated for him for the whole week.
Tant'è che nell'arco di questi anni che...
In all these years since this whole thing started, by discussing and meetings with artists and journalists and art critics, they have tried to define what and who a Modinaro really is, what a Modinaro is. And he said, is a Modinaro an artist? Yes. Is he a painter? That too. Is he an actor? Yes, that too. An entertainer? Yes. Is he a bum, a vagabond? Yes. A young man and a student? Also. All of these things are Modinari. He said Modinaro is a person that through his art he entertains, he creates a show.
Con la recitazione.
The art of the Modinaro is theater art. And what he said before is, teatro dell'arte, theater art is an Italian term that means basically the classic entertainment arts. And he says that can be done through music, through dancing, through actual theater, and also to what the Modinari do. He says it is not just painting. He says, I'm not putting down painters at all, because they also have their place. But what the Modinaro is not a painter, or at least it is definitely not just a painter. And he says, you go to these towns, to these places, and there are these young art students who work, on the floor. They're doing their art on the pavement, and because they're art students, they can be very punctilious, very precise, and they are very detailed and slow, and the crowd is just bored. And he said sometimes, just to liven them up, he'll just go there and start drawing something like within 2 seconds really quickly to get their attention, get the people's attention. And he says sometimes he's done it so fast, and when he looks at it, he says, oh my God, what have I done? This is terrible. He says, nonetheless, people will pay more attention to him than to these other kids, because, he says, you have to, as a Modinaro, you have to entertain the crowd, you have to grab the crowd, you have to get the crowd emotionally involved in what the artist is doing. Because, he said, the big cities have a frenetic rhythm. Everything moves fast. You have to do something that grabs the people and stops them. Many of you are actually artists. He said, one of the differences that I know between the Modinaro, the painting made by Modinaro, and what he calls I don't know the translation of this, but he says intimist painting. When he says intimate, it means in an intimate setting, which is like a painter's studio. That would be a more intimate setting. So one of the main differences between these two art forms is the perspective. He says, of course, a painter that works in a studio, in an art studio, has a vertical perspective, because the canvas is up high. He has to have an horizontal perspective because he's drawing on the floor. And everything changes because of that. So he'll say, imagine, and he was standing there, that I'm painting a face that starts here, that goes from here to over there. And it has to be clear to people who are walking up to it. So it's completely different. The perspective is totally different. He says the chin will be much smaller, the head will be much bigger, and he says he's constantly drawing line down and then getting up and looking, and then drawing line down and getting up and looking to see the perspective. So that is one of the differences.
Tant'è che ho dipinto il ritratto di Madonna, la cantante, per una rivista di musica. Appunto, i Madonnari dipingono Madonna, no? A Milano, ed era un volto della cantante che era lungo 4 metri.
Ok, posso tradurre velocemente?
Sì.
Grazie. So he said, as a matter of fact, he did a painting of Madonna, the singer, for a magazine, which, you know, who put it under the title, The Madonnari Paint Madonna, and her face was 4 meters long.
Wow. Il problema qual è stato? Che il fotografo, non conoscendo appunto l'arte dei Madonnari, è arrivato attrezzatissimo, grandi macchine fotografiche e soprattutto grande scala con cavalletto per fotografarlo dall'alto. Insomma, in alcune foto, quelle fatte dal punto che dicevo io di fotografare, era Madonna. Quelle fatte dalla scala, purtroppo non era più Madonna, ma era E.T. Assomigliava più a E.T. che alla Madonna, che a Madonna okay. La cantante.
So he said the problem was that the magazine sent their own very well-equipped photographer to take the picture of this artwork. Not being acquainted with the concept of the Madonnaro, the photographer came with every kind of sophisticated equipment under the sun, including a very large and high ladder, so that he could photograph the picture from above. Well, that is not how you're supposed to look at a painting from the Madonnaro. So he said, some of the pictures which the photographer took under Nedo's directions, from their perspective that Nedo explained, came out fine. But the other pictures, the one from above, made Madonna did not look like Madonna, but like E.T.
Yeah,
the head is huge.
We work knowing already that our base color is gray.
Per esempio,
or
vedo
black.
Quel dipinto.
For instance, I see that painting.
Io lì, avendo nero come base,
if I had black like that,
non userò quasi mai il nero,
I will
perché
never
ce l'ho già
black
nel pavimento.
Because I already have it on the floor. That's the base on the ground.
Un'altra cosa, il nero nel gessetto va usato pochissimo.
Black on chalk has to be used very little anyway, very sparingly.
Quando per esempio facciamo volti o quello del genere che ci serve rimarcare, sono gli ultimi colpi di gessetto che noi andiamo a dare.
You use it a little bit.
Perché se io uso il nero,
underline the faces here and there very sparingly. Because if I use black,
perché il nero noi dobbiamo usarlo per fare delle linee.
Only for lines.
Per
create make lines.
Ecco, il nero così, ma se io lo vado a toccare mi diventa, mi va a sporcare tutto.
It gets everything dirty, everything becomes dirty.
Vedete che mi rende tutto grigio.
Everything becomes grey.
Per quel discorso che si unisce al
because,
gesso che abbiamo messo prima.
Once again check,
quindi non sarà più un nero
together,
ma diventa un grigio e
so
spesso
no
succede
black.
Che tanti per esempio fanno i bordi.
So often many make
so, invece
borders
di usare,
in black.
Se, invece del nero dobbiamo usare un marron scuro.
You want to use dark brown.
Dobbiamo usare altri tipi di colore, insomma. Ecco. Possiamo usare questo che non mi va ad ingrigire niente.
Well, this will not turn things gray.
Vedete che non ingrigisce.
See, this does not create
gray. Invece il nero ingrigisce tantissimo.
But black does just turn everything to gray, all gray.
Vedete l'effetto che
see the effect?
Se noi andiamo a fare un viso
if we go and make a face,
per rimarcare le zone d'ombra nel
the
viso, nel naso,
the face,
nella bocca,
the
nel
nose,
torno agli occhi, ecco, mai usare
eyes.
Il nero.
Never use black.
Usiamo un marron scuro.
Dark brown.
E poi alla fine.
At the end.
Alla fine possiamo se abbiamo fatto un occhio.
If you say you drew an eye. No?
Then. Prima usiamo
first you use
il marron,
the brown,
che così non andiamo a sporcare niente.
So we don't make anything dirty, anything gray.
Anche per vedete?
Sì.
Vabbè, dopo qui c'è il bianco.
So now I put some white here.
Il nero lo usiamo alla fine.
At the very, very, very end you use a little black.
Quando dobbiamo rimarcare basta.
When you have to sort of go over, that's all.
Con un passaggio solo.
With one stroke, one time. One passage, literally.
Perché altrimenti andiamo a sporcare tutto.
Otherwise everything will be made dirty.
Vedete che il nero l'ho usato proprio nei colpi finali, perché altrimenti va ad ingrigire tutto.
Can you see I use black within in the final strokes, just in the final strokes, to avoid that grayness.
Dobbiamo rimarcare.
Rimarcare è sort of like underline, emphasize.
Quindi con poco facciamo. Ecco, l'importante è.
L'important thing.
Poi non è che, vabbè, l'esperienza di usare il gessetto vi porterà a capire che dopo un errore, due errori, ho sbagliato tutto, no? Ho messo il nero che non dovevo.
You'll know what you're
Perché è quello
to do.
Lo arriva con l'esperienza, insomma, piano
experience
piano.
Shows you, little by little.
Dopo il gessetto è anche una materia molto, molto morbida, molto soffice.
Chalk is very soft.
Noi amiamo molto, come, ecco, vedete, anche se ho fatto solo un occhietto di prova, però vedete che la tendenza è quella di ritornare,
a ritoccare, a ripulire.
Però bisogna farlo con molta delicatezza.
Very delicately. Very, very delicately.
Delicatezza perché è proprio una polverina che noi andiamo ad appoggiare. Quindi vedete che se io, ogni volta che io ci passo il dito, modifica.
Every time I put my finger on it, it modifies the whole thing.
Non avendo nessun altro materiale a disposizione, bisogna avere, ecco, una cosa importante. Che se siete a terra, un cuscino.
Per essere un po' più comodi
e munirsi di tanta pazienza e
And also a lot of patience and a light touch.